हेलो एवरीवन एंड दिस इज द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ ऑपरेशन रिसर्च सब्जेक्ट एंड द कोर्स कोड ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट इज ME405 यूनिट नंबर 3 एंड लेक्चर नंबर 19 एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक रिगार्डिंग डिसीजन ट्रीज एंड दिस टॉपिक गिव्स द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द हाउ मच डिसीजन इज डिवाइडेड इनटू द डिफरेंट स्टेप्स एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द बेटर डिसीजन right with examples different types of examples like taken as a some manufacturing type of example some example taken from the goods for the mind expect from this for my introduction myself Rahul Kumar assistant professor of department of mechanical engineering Suresh Gyan Vihar University Jaipur so let's start this today lecture This is the decision trees and for the these are the objectives regarding the decision trees and for the decision tree the at the end of the chapter or this lecture the student able to understand about the determination of the decision trees for organization means how to draw the one decision tree for the organization and understand the concept of decision tree analysis for the and better understand the concept of the decision tree analysis and understand the people solving techniques and how to people solve the techniques from the decision trees so this is a one kinds of techniques which resolve the very difficult problem related to the operation research right and this gives the one good and it will also provide the one good decision for the any decision making or thinker person so for this decision tree so the main aim or objectives for this decision tree is here it provides a decision which is helpful or good for the organization for betterment of future and next thing is here this is the example of the decision tree so this example shows the state of nature which have a different type of strategies and that strategies are strategy 1 this is the strategy 1 and this is the strategy 2 and which will gives the outcome of the two kinds first one is state 1 and the state 2 outcomes then strategy 1 gives the and it can say that it is again divided into two steps right and which will divided into the two steps this is give the outcome 1 and outcome 2 and this is the strategy 2 gives the outcome of outcome 3 and outcome 4 for this we find the or we are making the decision tree diagram for this for the decision trees problem and this is a just I have already told this is a problem of strategy 1 and strategy 2 then here are the two states state 1 and 2 and this state divided into the strategy of 1 and two and one and two these two states again divided into the again activities just like as a outcome 1 and outcome 2 and the outcome 3 and outcome 4 also so the way which I am talking about the decision trees right and decision tree is a diagram or chart so here one kind of this is a one diagram is given here in your slide and this is the source of the diagram is here source of the diagram just like is strategies here are the two strategies strategies 1 and strategy 2 and these again split into the two types one is outcome 1 and outcome 2 and the outcome 3 and outcome 4 also so the decision tree are this gives the information regarding the diagram or a chart that helps to determine the course of action or show the statistical probabilities. And the chart is called the decision tree due to its resemble to the namesake plant, right? Because this can divide into the one type of trees, right? So starting from the decision itself called node. Suppose this is the strategy one, this is called the node, and this is given by the one rectangle here, right? And the each branch, these are the two branches, just like the 1 and 2, where is given 1 and 2, this is the one kind of branches, and the outcome branch of the decision trees which represent a possible decision, which represent a possible decision and the outcome. And outcome, this is the last stage of this tree is here, means where if you getting a different kinds of outcomes from these trees. So this is the last thing. Suppose in the case of tree is here, so at the downside just like the tana, and then some stem, and then leaf are present here, and like this here, right? And the furthest branches on the tree represent and end result of a certain decision pathways and are called the leaves. So these outcomes, these kinds of outcomes, like these outcomes called the leaves of this decision trees. And some people use decision tree to verify the clarify the map out and find the answer to the complex problem, and decision tree are frequently employed in determining for the course action in the finance, investing, businesses and in mathematics also. And we can use the complex probability equations with the help of tree diagram. And then move to the next step or next slide. In the case of decision trees, so decision tree, it will give the one type of network which exhibits graphically the relationship between the different parts of the complex decision process and the it gives also a graphical method of each combination of various acts and states of nature, along with their payoffs. Probability distribution are used, and with the help of decision tree, people use decision tree in the variety of situations, such as determining a course of action for a complex finance or business decisions, right? And this type of tree is extremely useful in multi-stage situation, and which involve a number of decisions, and each depending on the proceeding one, means which decision is just like as related to the first decision, means your last decision related to the first decision also. So for this in the decision tree, each end result has an assigned risk and reward weight or numbers. If the person uses a decision tree to make a decision, then can look at each final outcomes and assess the benefits of the drawbacks, and the each branch of the decision tree represent a possible decision which shows the outcome or reactions. The furthest branches on the tree represent the end result of a certain decision pathways. So decision trees give the various activities for this path, and the decisions are given by only higher authorities in your organization. Higher authorities in your organization only. So this is very fruitful to the organization in the future. So we can say that this decision tree gives the big problem into the different kinds of results, right? And these results is very helpful for the run a good organization, right? So here decision tree consists of different types of benefits for your are different types of elements. These elements are nodes, branches. These are the nodes, branches, probability estimates, and payoff also. These are the nodes, branches, probability estimate, and payoff also. And there are three types of nodes. There are three types of node, and these nodes are decision nodes, chance node, and the terminal nodes. These nodes are first is decision nodes, second is chance node, and third is the terminal nodes. So three nodes are given here. So first is here decision nodes, and the decision nodes represent by square. So in this last example, this gives a one type of square. This gives a one type of square, and this square gives the decision nodes, right? And which represent a point of action where a decision maker must select one alternative course, where the decision maker must select one alternative course of action among the available, right? So the next thing is here chance node. So the chance node represented by a circle. So suppose previous slide shows the circle. Two activities are here, one and two, which represent the circle activities, right? So this is called the chance node, and it indicates a point of time where the decision maker will discover the response on his decision, where the decision maker responsible for the decision for this decision. And the next is here terminal node. Terminal node represented by a triangle, right? It represented by a triangle, but this is a optional type of node. This is a optional type of nodes, and for this which solves a three involves pairing all but of the best decision at the decision nodes and finding accept values of all possible state of nature at chance of the node, and which also create a tree from left to right and solve the tree from right to left. Suppose you want to create it, if you want to create a tree, then you move from left to right side. And if you solve this problem, then you move to right to left side. Just reverse both of two. So these are the three kinds of nodes. First is decision nodes, chance node, and the terminal nodes is here, right? So yeah, this is a formula. Yeah, this is a diagram which shows the decision tree example. This is a one kind of example, and in this case, shows the decision nodes. Which type of this is the one rectangle type of nodes or square type of nodes, which are the decision nodes, and this is responsible for the this type. This is the square node, which is the decision node, and it represent the point of action where the decision maker must select one alternative course of action among of the above, right? So for this case, decision making case, and it also splits into two types of, and this is decision, it is the one example. This is a one example. This gives the information about the in the rainy season. Suppose if you want to go outside your house, then sometime rain will happen and sometime rain will not happen. So this type of so you bring the umbrella or not. So this is the very typical decision, because so for this case, this decision is converted into the two types. First we go with umbrella or without go umbrella, means these are the two is here. This is the chance node. The circle is shows the chance node. So it gives the go with umbrella and go without umbrella. This is depend on your choice. But here is this chance node is again divided into the two type of, and this is the outcome of the problem. So outcome of the problem gives the information related to the rain. If rain is it will occur, then you move to the stay comfortable and dry case. And if rain is not occur, means no rain is here, so we are unnecessary trouble of carrying umbrella. So why to create unnecessary trouble of the carrying umbrella, and you always holds one device, right? And go without umbrella. For the go without umbrella, this is the case of rain and no rain. For the if you want to go without umbrella from the outside, if rain will it will come, then the decision is here. You wait and you feel like at a uncomfortable sense. You feel like at a uncomfortable sense, and in the case of no rain is coming, and remain dry or and comfortable. In this case, remain dry or comfortable. So in this case, so here these outcomes are divided into the four steps. And one step is here, and chance is here too, means go with umbrella and go without umbrella, and this is the strategy, and this gives the decision nodes. This is the chance node and this is the outcome nodes, right? So these are the different kinds of structures in this decision tree example. So decision tree it is very important and helpful to find the decision, and for the decision tree, an organization may deploy decision takes a kind of decision support system, and the structural model allows to the reader of the chart to see how and why one choice may lead to the next, means one choice how to lead to the next with the use of the branches indicating manually exclusive options. And this structure allows the user to take a problem with multiple possible solutions, and to display those solutions in a simple easy to understand format and allows shows the relationship between different events or decisions also, between the different events or decisions also. So in this decision tree, end of the result, each end gives a one kind of result. So this result has a assigned risk or reward. Wait, suppose in this example, if you stay comfortable and dry, then no trouble it will happen. Rain will come, but you have a umbrella. Rain will come, but you have a umbrella. So for this case, you stay comfortable and dry in this case. But so this is a reward point. If you have an umbrella, but rain will not come, so you create a trouble here. So it creates a unnecessary trouble for carrying umbrella. So it creates a unnecessary trouble of carrying umbrella, and then go without umbrella. For this case, go without umbrella. So the rain will come and get wet and uncomfortable. Get wet and uncomfortable. If rain will come, then they remain dry and comfortable, right? If rain is not come and you have no umbrella, so in this case remain dry and comfortable. Means you are comfortable for this case. So this is the best example for the decision making processes here. And these are the elements of decision theory. And this is the elements of decision theory. First one is state of nature, alternatives, payoff. And in the case of alternatives, which gives the state of nature could be defined as low demand and high demand. Means this type of decision making process define the low and high demand for this case. And next is alternatives. Alternatives gives the VGK decide to build a VGK decide to build a small, medium or large flour processing mill. Means this type of alternatives gives a different types of small industries, and the payoff is it is a one kind of profit given to the organization. So payoff of each alternative under each potential state of nature is going to be determined. And we develop different models for this problem on this following slides here. So here are the different advantages for the decision tree, and this gives the visual and systematic approach to break down decision making. It gives the visual and systematic approach breaking down decision making process, and the it also provide the clearly outline the long term impacts of making certain decision. And decision trees can also express trade off and possibilities. So in this kind of result, first I will take VGK flour mill company example, and which build a small, medium and a large whole flour processing mills. So for this case, this is a one kind of VGK flour mill payoff table. And in this table shows the small is here state of nature, low is here 8, high is 8. So medium in the case of low 5, high 15. And here large is minus 11 and 12. So the one unit is divided into the three chance node here. This gives the three chance node of this company. So for this chance node is here 1, 2, 3. These are the three chance node which gives the information about small unit, medium enterprise unit and the large unit here. So the how much profit in locks of rates. So this is a profit payoff table, and all chance node divided into the two steps, which gives the low demand and high demand. It will give the high small units create the only at a type of profit. So in the medium enterprises, it gives the, if low demand is here, then it will give the 5 payoff profit. Profit is here 5 lakhs, and if a high demand for the medium enterprises, then it will give the profit of 15 lakhs. And for the large setting, if low demand is here, then it provides a minus 11 lakh loss of this organization. It provide the 11 lakh loss of this organization. So for the large setting and high demand is here, so if high demand in the market, so it will provide a 22 lakh profit. So for this case, here in this case flour mill company, only medium enterprises company are good for this case. If low demand, so it will give a 5 lakh profit. If high demand, it will give a 15 lakh profit. But here a loss is not, it will happen. Not loss will not happen for this case. So it always provide the one type of profit also. One type of profit. And suppose this is a positive thing. This is, but here is in large demand, because if you have a large company, so your workers is large, your final asset is large, and you take the, if you want to open the very large enterprises company, then you take a very high loan, money with a very high loan, so your bias, just like it, interest for the money, this is more also. If you not give a very good profit, so you go in the large, because some final some initial charges, just like it, labor cost, electricity cost, land cost, or if you want maintain this type of organization, so this cost is associated in this here. So you if low demand is here, so you will give a minus 11 lakh loss. So better for this here, it will give a medium enterprises company. Small is also good, but it creates a not a tremendous one fabulous profit for this case. So here is profit is only 8 lakhs for this case. But in the case of medium enterprises, are the medium enterprises at the low demand, it will give the 5 lakhs, and this is shows the 3 lakh less from the small unit. But in the case of high demand, so it will give say 15 lakh profit. So here is profit is more for the medium enterprises. So move to the next slide about the decision making under risk condition. So here is risk is not associated with it, but some cases risk is also given. So how to take decision for this situation. So this slide gives the information regarding decision making under risk condition. So the if risk is associated in your decision, then you adopt the probability studies. For this studies, each possible state of nature has a assumed probability pi. Suppose for the any example, so state of nature are mutually exclusive, and possibilities must be sum of 1 is here, and determine the expected mandatory values EMV. This is the expected mandatory value EMV for each alternative. Then the expected monetary value, it gives the summation of I equal to 1 to n, summation of I equal 1 to n, pi, this is the pi and capital xi suffix, where xi is the ith outcome of this decision, ith outcome of the decision, and pi is the probability of the ith decision, probability of the ith outcome decision, and n is the total number of possible outcomes. May say in your company, means suppose 20 outcomes is given, so this is the n is the total number of possible outcomes, right? This is the EMV example. For this case here, the alternative of the construct large plant A1 and construct small plant A2. If you want to this, then probability market 200,000 dollar, here is 100,000 dollar. So if do nothing, then it will give the 50, and the probability is 0.5 and 0.5 for both case. And this is a favorable market and this is the unfavorable market, both case. So for this case is here, these are the EMVs for A1, 0.5, just like it gives the $10,000, and EMV A2, A2 gives the $40,000. But in the case of EMV A3, here the cost is here associated with $0, it gives the $0 cost. So best option is for this case is here, best option is here $40,000, right? So EMV A2 gives the $40,000. So this is the best option for this case. Then but here, okay, this is a construct large plant, this is a minus 180,000, this gives the unfavorable market. So this is the 40,000, this is the best option for this case. Best option for this case. So this is the decision making under risk condition, and this is the expected monetary value, expected monetary value for this case, right? And move to the next problem related to the decision making decision tree process. And this is the expected opportunity loss, which is in short form said EOL. EOL means expected opportunity lost. Loss is here. So it is the opposite of EMV. It is opposite of EMV analysis. So EOL is defined as the difference between the highest profit or payoff and the actual profit due to choosing a particular course of action in a particular state of nature. So in conditional opportunity loss, EOL for a particular course of action is determined by taking the difference between the payoff value of the most favorable course of action and some other course of action. So this is the one conditional opportunity which provide the expected opportunity loss, and this expected opportunity loss gives the which is opposite to the EMV value, and EMV value means expected mandatory value, right? For this purpose we have taken example related to the EMV and EOL values in the next slide. Here this is the opportunity loss matrix. In the opportunity loss matrix gives the first is act, cold weather and the warm weather. If the cold weather it will comes, then it gives a profit of 60 and minus 40 it will give. So this is an example of opportunity loss matrix. for this case, some first decision you want to hear, sell cold drinks. And this is the cold weather. In the cold weather, only sells out of 60, only 40 cold drink are sold for this case. And in the case of warm weather condition, here the 90 means 19 minus 90, it will give a 0, means loss of the matrix is here 0. But sell in ice cream for the cold weather, here is 60 minus 60 0, and 90 minus 40, this is a 50 here, loss of here 50. So the case of the EOL for each alternative course of action is computed as below. So sell cold drinks is equal to 0.3 into 20 into 0.7 into 0 equal to 6 is here. And for the sell ice creams, this gives the 0.3 into 0 plus 0.7 into 0.7 into 50 equal to 35. So since UL is the minimum in case of selling cold drink, and the this is the best act for this case, and then sell cold drinks, this gives the 75 rupees of loss, and the here is 46. So since EMV is the more of selling cold drinks, it is recommended. This is the difference between EMV and the EOL here. So first we have studied the different examples, and in this case this is the expected value of perfect information, expected value of the perfect information, and this is the difference of the expected payoff under certainty and the expected payoff under risk. This gives the information regarding the under payoff under the certainty condition and the expected payoff under risk condition. So it is a expected value of the perfect information, this is equal to expected payoff under certainty minus expected payoff under risk, right? So EVPI is defined as the maximum amount. EVPI means expected value of perfect information. This gives the maximum amount of one would pay to obtain perfect information about the state of the nature of that would occur. So this is the one thing for the case of EVPI. Then move to the next slide for the next. And this is the experimental design. I will give some management examples. First is sales productivity experiment, and the self space experiment, direct mail experiment, and the pricing experiment is here. For the sales productivity experiment here, we will increase in the average number of sales calls per customers from 6 to 8 per year, significantly improve sales. We decreasing the self space allocated to brand X detergent by the 25%, significantly lower its sale. So any X brand of company which reduces the 25% sale, it is called the self space experiment. Then the direct mail experiment, it will be the worthwhile to mail last year donors of the attractive but expensive brochure describing the company activities and soliciting higher contribution of this year. For the pricing experiment, can a company improve the profitability of its fashion clothing line by increasing its price by 10%? So this is the one way for the pricing experiment is here. And then move to the next section of this lecture. This is the MCQ section, means multiple choice question answer segment. then move to this segment also. In this MCQ section, this is your first question. First question of the MCQ is the decision support tool that uses a tree-like graph or model of decisions and their possible consequences including chance event outcomes, resource cost and utility, and the tree in decision support tool. Suppose, so the correct answer is here, decision tree. A is the correct answer for this question, right? So move to the next question. This is the second question of this MCQ problem. And what is decision tree? Flow chart. Here four option is given. First one is flow chart, structure in which internal node represent test on an attribute, each branch represent outcome of test, and each leaf node represent class level. And flow chart and structure is a in which internal node represent test on an attribute, and each branch represents outcome of test, and each leaf node represent class level, and none of the mentioned here. So the correct answer is here flow chart, right? A is the correct answer. Then move to the question number 3. Choose from the following that are decision trees nodes. Decision nodes, end node, and chance node, and the all of the above mentioned. So choose the from the following that are decision tree nodes. This is the all are this is the decision nodes. This decision nodes A is the right answer for this question. Then move to the next question. Decision nodes are represented by, here four options is given. First one is disk, B square, C circle, and D is triangles. So what is the correct answer for this question? So decision nodes always represented by a squares. Always represented by a square. So the correct answer is here square is the correct answer for this question. The coefficient of variation measures the risk per unit of expected payoff, the risk adjusted expected value, and the payoff per unit risk, and the decision makers risk return trade-off. So the correct answer of this problem is here B is the risk adjusted expected value, right? So move to the sixth question. In this case, end node are represented by first one is disk, square, circle, triangle. So end node is always represented by the circles also. In the case of circles, right? C is the right answer. Sometimes it may be represented by the disk, right? So A is the right answer for this question. Sorry for this. A is the right. And circumstances that influences the probability of a decision are referred to as strategies, a payoff matrix, state of nature, and the marginal utility of money. So the correct answer for is here a payoff matrix are referred as a probability. This is the states of nature. C is the right answer for this question. And then move to the next question, question number 8. A marginal utility of money dimensions for a decision maker who is a risk seeker, risk neutral, a risk averter, and in a situation of uncertainty. So this is a risk seeker. A is the right answer for this question. And then move to the next question. A strategy that yields an expected monetary payoff of zero is called a risk neutral strategy, fair game, zero sum game, and certainty equivalent. So the for this here is risk neutral strategy. A is the right answer for this question. Then move last question. Then this is the question number 10. Which of the following are the advantages of decision trees? Which gives the possible scenarios can be added, Use a void box model if given result is provided by a model. Worst, best and expected values can be determined for different scenario. And last is all of the mentioned here. So in this case, all of the mentioned, this is the right answer for this question. And this is the right answer, and then move to the next. These are the different kinds of references which I have used in this chapter, in this lecture. So just follow, go through it. And thank you for this kind attention for this lecture, and thank you all of you. And in the next lecture, I will discuss the some decision theory related problem in the next lecture. And thank you all of you for this, for again. Thank you.